Hi, and welcome to the video on how to find a popular magazine, website, or newspaper article that reports the findings of a scientific research article. Let's start with the definition. What is a popular article? A popular article is typically written by a journalist or a writer for hire and is intended to inform a general audience. Popular articles are different from scholarly articles in a few key ways, such as the credentials of the author, where it is published, and why the article exists. Oftentimes, a popular article will attempt to translate a scientific article so that the general audience and not just subject experts can easily understand the findings. And while scholarly articles always provide a list of citations at the end, popular articles aren't always great at providing pathways to their sources. You can find popular articles in many places on the web and in print. Specifically, you can find them in newspapers, such as the New York Times and our local newspaper, The Oregonian. Typically, there's a science or a health section, so try to find those sections first. You can also use a web magazine, such as Environmental News Network, Wired, National Geographic, and Scientific American. Just use Google to locate those web pages and either browse through their issues, or you can even do a search within that web page. You can also explore radio websites such as NPR Science Friday. At the end of this video, I'm going to give you an additional tip on how to choose a viable article from one of these sources. I'm going to use, for my example, the New York Times Science section to find my popular article. If you've used the New York Times website to access their content, then you probably already know that it limits you to click and read only 5 articles per month, so browse wisely. I ran out of my 5 articles just at the moment when I thought I found an interesting one. And because PSU Library subscribes to the New York Times, I can find and access the full text of the article through the library's website. Here's how I did it. First, I'll navigate to the website, library.pdx.edu, and then I'll navigate down to the Databases and Articles link, and then I'll use the A to Z menu near the top to find the New York Times, under the letter N. So once I'm in the New York Times, I'll enter the title of my article into the search box, and I'm going to cross my fingers and hope it pops right up. So you may need to add in some additional information to your search, maybe an author's last name or a keyword to help you narrow down your results. Oh, great. I'm so lucky. Here's my article. And I know I'm going to need a citation for my popular article. So I'm going to go ahead and collect the details for that citation right now. And that just makes it nice and easy for me. I don't have to go back later and try to find all these details. If you're using a library database like I am, they will have a citation feature within it that you can use to grab that citation information. But if you're using a website, you will have to collect this information on your own. You'll be looking for the title, the author, the source it was published in my case, that would be the New York Times, a volume and issue number if it's available. So sometimes on websites, that's not something that you'll find there. The date the information was published, the pages, again, if it's available, and where you found it. So for a website, that would be the URL of the website itself. Finally, I'd like to share one last tip for choosing a popular article, and that is to be mindful of articles reporting on current events. In this research timeline, notice that it can take months, yes, months, for researchers to collect, analyze, and publish a scholarly article. Even then, there is typically a lag time between when these articles are published in print and when they are available in library databases. Please take this into consideration when you're choosing your popular articles. Has enough time passed for the scientific research to be published?